So I probably spent about 180 days on the road, so definitely gone a lot. And so when it comes to my kids, as well as Sabrina, my wife, wanting to stay close to them is something near and dear to my heart. And so it really takes a commitment and an effort to do it, because you can get lost in the travel and the business and the tiredness that comes with that. And so it takes a commitment of being willing to stay connected several different ways. And so one is via text. So sending them text messages, be it I love you text messages, funny videos in the morning, something silly and just funny just to try to wake them up in the morning, depending on what time zone I'm in. Sending that stuff and being dedicated to that helps a ton. Before traveling, what I've learned to do is write love notes. That helps a ton as well. So I write sticky notes and love notes and hide them all over the house in places that I know they'll find them. Sometimes I tuck it in their book bag, be it their lunchbox, their coat, their shoes, and just writing a love note to my wife Sabrina, my two daughters. That helps a ton, so that when dad's away, you know, you open your lunchbox and you have this funny face note from dad, you know, that you see. And so that's another way that I found to really stay connected with them. The other way is really having a great re-entry program. And so what I mean by that is that when you're gone, sometimes it's tough to re-engage with the family. And so as I'm flying back, I'm constantly thinking of ways to really re-engage my family, be it dinner, be it some type of activity that I know they'll want to do, be it watch a show that they like, be it, you know, draw or do some kind of arts and crafts. Just what can dad do that's wild and crazy and fun to re-engage the family? That helps a ton there. And then on top of that, we realize that as a family, the Willis family is different, and you and your family have to do what works for you as well. And so for us, sometimes taking my kids out of school a day or two for them to travel with dad. And so my daughters get a chance to travel once a quarter with dad, and they jump on the plane and I'm daddy with the daughter for a day or two by myself, you know, and they actually come and they present with me in front of a client, which is fun for them to get a chance to see what dad does, but then also have that daddy-daughter time, because I'll plan out some type of fun activity. So we'll do a fun activity, then we'll go to work, you know, and then fly to the next city. And so those kinds of things ultimately helps me to stay engaged with them. And then I think the last thing is really making it a priority. You have to write it in your journal, write it on your calendar. So for me, I think about date nights to take my daughters and Sabrina out, and not just your traditional date nights, just kind of wild, crazy things. So for example, one of my daughters, she loves to cook. And so one of our date nights coming up is a cooking class together. Just her and I going to for 2 hours, and we're going to cook dinner, and then we'll sit down and eat the dinner that we cooked at a place, you know, at a local place. So we'll have a chef teach us and train us how to use knife skills and all that. And so she'll love that. And my other daughter who wants to learn self-defense, I'm looking to see if we can do a daddy-daughter self-defense night where her and I, we just go and learn some self-defense moves, and we learn how to just really kick butt and have a good time doing it and laugh and joke and doing that. And so I think doing that monthly, as well as the text messages and the love notes and those kinds of things, even if you're working a ton, even if you're gone, it shows them that they're a priority for you, and it helps them really engage and you engage with them as well.